Hello and welcome to Better Geology. I'm Andrew Dunning and I'm at Mount Tabor Park in Portland. Mount Tabor Park has become a very popular park, but it started out life as a cinder cone around 2 million years ago. And because of its development into a park and the excavation of a section of the hillside into a amphitheater, the various stages of the formation of a cinder cone can be easily seen. Over in this part of the excavation, we can see that there's a wide variety of rocks, both in size and in texture. And this is because this is very close to the vent of the cinder cone when it was erupting, where the largest and most wide variety of ejecta and cinders were deposited on the flanks of the growing cinder cone. As we move towards the outside of the volcano, we can see that the size of rocks tends to get smaller. And then we get to a certain point where large rocks disappear altogether, and the beds of cinders and ash become stratified into beds and layers. Now this is the edge of the where the cinder cone grew from its cinders alone. But past here, we can see that the layers are all stratified, and this is mostly very small cinders, mostly less than a couple inches wide, and interbedded with ash and sand and other volcanic debris. Cinder cones don't explode in large pyroclastic eruptions, so we don't have fine, tough beds like we see in other larger volcanoes. And as we move even further toward the very edge of the hillside, the particles get smaller and smaller until they become no more than sand. Mount Tabor is part of the Boring Volcanic Field, which is a field of monogenetic cinder cones that is inside and around the city limits of Portland, Oregon, and is what makes Portland one of the very few cities in the world that has volcanoes within its perimeters. Most of the cinder cones and volcanoes of the Boring Volcanic Field have been worn away and are almost unidentifiable as cinder cones from their shape alone due to a large cataclysmic series of floods called the Missoula Floods, which started from a glacier field in Montana and Canada, and that eroded away the once perfectly conical sides of the volcanoes into rounded, subdued hills. This has been Better Geology. I'm Andrew Dunning. Thank you for watching.